Hello. Welcome to Resurrection Lutheran Church.
Welcome to worship at Resurrection Lutheran Church. We're glad to have you with us. Whether you be joining us on Sunday morning or throughout the week, it's always great to have you as part of our worshiping community. It is the third Sunday in the Epiphany season, January 24th. And so today we're going to hear God's word. It's a call to change, to repent. And when we hear it, Jesus adds to that call to repent with some urgency. It's now that it needs to happen. It's immediately that this needs to take place. And we turn from sin, but we also trust that God's promise and God's kingdom is already upon us. And it's time to follow Jesus. Also today, we have the prophet Jonah, a reluctant prophet to begin with, who for Jonah, the good news for one group is bad news for him. So today we will celebrate communion, so if you have an opportunity to have bread and cup available, we encourage you can pause the recording and do that at this time. As part of our pattern of worship that we are continuing in this Epiphany season is we are sharing repeating together, our welcome statement as a congregation. And so let us begin. We believe God loves everyone. As disciples of Jesus, we actively seek to live life in fellowship with the beautiful spectrum of diversity made manifest in the body of Christ. As Lutheran Christians, we respond in faith to the grace God first extends to us. This grace extends to all of God's creation. We recognize that many have not experienced God's all-encompassing welcome from the established church. We specifically welcome all people, including all races and ethnicities, gender and sexual orientation, ages, economic levels, and abilities. We invite you to join us as together we seek to respond in faith to God's as God's hands and feet in the world. This is our welcome statement. And we sing. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Come set your rule and reign in our hearts again. Increase in us, we pray. Unveil while we're made. Come set our hearts ablaze with hope like wildfire in our very souls. Holy Spirit, come invade us now. We are your church. We need your power in us. We seek your kingdom first. We hunger and we thirst. Refuse to waste our lives, for you're our joy and prize. To see the captive's hearts, release the hurt, the sick, the poor at peace. We lay down our lives for heaven's cause. We are your church. We pray, revive this earth. Build your kingdom here. Let the darkness fear. Show your mighty hand. Heal our streets and land. Set your church on fire. Win this nation. Your kingdom's power, reaching the near and far. No force of hell can stop your beauty changing hearts. You made us for much more than this. Awake the kingdom seed in us. Fill us with the strength and love of Christ. We are your church. We are the hope on earth. Build your kingdom here. Let the darkness fear. Show your mighty hand. Heal our streets and land. Set your church. Win this nation back. Change the atmosphere. Build your kingdom here, we pray.
We pray together the prayer of the day. Almighty God, by grace alone, you call us and accept us in your service. Strengthen us by your Spirit and make us worthy of your call. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
Will you let my love be shown? Will you let my name? Will you come and follow me if I but call your name? Will you go where you don't know and never be the same? Will you let my love be shown? Will you let my name be known? Will you let my life be grown in you and you? Will you leave yourself behind if I but call your name. Will you care for cruel and kind and never be the same? Will you risk the hostile stare? Should your life attract or scare? Will you let me answer prayer in you and you? Will you love the you hide if I but call your name? Will you quell the fear inside and never be the same? Will you use the faith you found to reshape the world around? Through my sight and touch and sound in you and you. Your summons echo true when you but call my name. Let me turn and follow you and never be the same. In your company I'll go, where your love and footsteps show. Thus I'll move and live and grow.
Today's reading is from the third chapter of Jonah. The word of the Lord came to Jonah a second time, saying, "Get up, go to Nineveh, that great city, and proclaim it to the message that I tell you." So Jonah set out and went to Nineveh, according to the word of the Lord. Now Nineveh was an exceedingly large city, a 3 days' walk across. Jonah began to go into the city, going a day's walk, and he cried out, 40 days more, and Nineveh shall be overthrown. And the people of Nineveh believed God, and they proclaimed a fast. And everyone, great and small, put on a sackcloth. When God saw what they did and how they turned from their evil way, God changed his mind about the calamity that he had said he would bring upon them. And he did not do it. Word of God, word of life.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark, the first chapter. Now after John the Baptist was arrested, Jesus came to Galilee proclaiming the good news of God and saying, "The time is fulfilled. The kingdom of God has come near. Repent and believe in the good news." As Jesus passed along the Sea of Galilee, he saw Simon with his brother Andrew casting a net into the sea, for they were fishermen. And Jesus said to them, "Follow me, and I will make you fish for people." And immediately they left their nets and followed him. As he went a little further, he saw James, the son of Zebedee, and his brother John, who were in their boat mending the nets. Immediately he called them, and they left their father Zebedee in the boat with the hired men and followed Jesus. The Gospel of the Lord. Mercy, grace, and peace from the one who creates, redeems, and sustains. Amen. Sometimes Things just need to get done. You know, when that deadline looms, when that paper as a student just had to get done, when the crisis is already upon us, we need to act. No more excuses, no more delays, get it done. The time is fulfilled, we hear. The time to do something. It's a call to act. Now is that time, is what Jesus says. Now the kingdom is here because God is among us. Change your hearts and minds and lives because God is among us. This is good news. Now trust that good news. That's what the word believe means. Trust the good news because, again, God is among us. God is among us right now, in this place, in this time. And we can experience God's presence. What's interesting about this verse, it's all of this is in verse 15 of our gospel today. The verbs are plural here. This is not about my personal repentance or changing of my life. This is about the community. It's a we statement. And the whole world is going to be called to make this change as well, in their hearts and minds and lives and the actions that they do. So to call the disciples is not just about Simon or Andrew or James or John as individuals, but too often we do make this just about me or just about you. It's not my personal salvation. It is not Jesus as my personal Lord and Savior. Jesus is not mine. Jesus is not my personal Redeemer. Jesus is the Savior of the world, is what we sing. Jesus is a word that renews all of creation. And that's what Jesus' point is. So we get in this opening, these are the first words of Jesus in Mark's gospel. And we get this sense of now, immediately, is used twice in the same paragraph about the disciples' response. Mark loves to use this word. 41 times he uses the word, the Greek word, immediately. There is something demanding action right now. You know, we together, as a nation, as a community, we've experienced this urgent sense over the past few weeks, haven't we? We have seen the images on TV and in the newspaper and on our cell phones again and again that something is happening now. We have heard, you know, those hateful words repeated over and over. This whisper, this is not, I sometimes hear myself, this is not my America. Those are not my people. Which brings us to Jonah. We think we know the story, don't we? We've heard it in Sunday school. We've heard it in all sorts of other contexts. God calls Jonah to go preach to the Ninevites. Jonah runs away. He's thrown overboard when the storm comes. He's swallowed by a big fish. He's thrown up on the shores of Nineveh. He preaches the worst sermon in the history of the Bible. 40 days, Nineveh overthrown. That's his whole sermon. But that brings us to the text that we have today in Jonah. Nineveh was a brutal conqueror. Let's be clear about this. It destroyed the northern kingdom of Israel, and it punished the southern kingdom of Judah unmercifully. Jews hated Nineveh because it even became a curse word to call someone a Ninevite would say that they are hateful creatures. But here's the challenge. Jonah didn't run away from God because he was afraid of Nineveh and the Ninevites. Jonah runs away because Jonah is afraid that God will be merciful and he'll forgive. Jonah wanted Nineveh to be destroyed. So as I have been reflecting and thinking and trying to respond to what has been happening around us the last few weeks, you know, I realized this week as I was praying that I've had similar thoughts to Jonah's. Not just over the last few weeks, but to be honest, over the last 5 years. I believe that our country has been damaged by lies and hatred and greed and incompetence and selfish ambition. I was shocked over what has happened, but to be honest, I wasn't surprised that it did. I have tried to raise my concerns very gently with you as a congregation. And I'll be honest, and I felt guilty for not saying more. I have taken pleasure in seeing legacies ruined and those people being prosecuted. I am Jonah, sitting on the hill waiting for Nineveh to be destroyed. Hate is a really strong word, isn't it? And there have been times when hate was the only response I had left. And what I hear from Jesus, I don't have to like it. But what I hear from Jesus is that now is the time to deal with it. To deal with the fact that God is among us. And I'm called to act. I'm called to respond to God's call. The kingdom is here, it's now. And I'm called, we are called, change our hearts and our minds and our language and our lives. For the fact of the matter is this. The people that we hate, God loves. And we, the people, whoever that hate is directed to, God loves. I know that in my head, but sometimes it's there in my heart. And let's be clear, it doesn't matter what side you're on. The people you hate, God loves. We have to all bring our hearts and minds, our language and our lives together. That's the only thing that will heal our nation and heal our world. We may not be able to trust those others yet, But coming together as a faith community, as a city, as a nation, and as a world requires us to be working on that now. And it must be done. Because the brokenness can't continue if we are to continue. The hate has to stop now, even when we can't get let go of it. This is one part of the call that we all share at this time. The presence of God is with us now. What are we going to do about it? Can we trust the good news of God? Amen.
Listen.
Listen, God is calling, through the wood inviting, offering forgiveness, comfort, and joy.
Listen.
Listen, God is calling, through the wood inviting, offering forgiveness, comfort, and joy.
Jesus gave his mandate,
share the good news,
that he came to save us. Forgotten
throughout the world,
in the triune name of God,
go and baptize.
Listen.
Listen, God is calling, through the word inviting, offering forgiveness, comfort, and joy.
Listen.
Listen, God is calling, through the word inviting, offering forgiveness, comfort, and joy.
Help us to be faithful,
standing steadfast,
walking in your precepts,
led by your word.
Listen.
Listen, God is calling, through the word inviting, offering forgiveness, comfort, and joy.
Listen.
Listen, God is calling, offering forgiveness, comfort, and joy.
So let us pray. O God of the sunrise, lifter of light, spreader of gold and copper morning, unfurl this day before as your gift. Stuff our hearts with thankfulness as treasure. The brisk new day, the hours yet to fill. Let all we do with them reflect your love, that we may mirror back to you your glory. God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. O friend of sinners, Lord of gentleness, a single wounded reed you will not break. The smallest spark of faith receives your breath until the living coal ignites a fire that fuels the very sorry soul, that heals the heart. Kindle every fire that sleeps within us, that in this world we may be warmth and light. God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. I invite us to hold some silence right now. We can lift up our prayers and concerns and praise. But I specifically invite you to lift up that part that is in us right now, which doesn't reflect God's light, that doesn't reflect God's gentleness. It's those feelings and emotions that we just can't let go of. Let's hold some silence together. Merciful God, hear the prayers of your people, spoken or silent, for the sake of the one who dwells among us, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us share that peace with one another. We pray the offering prayer. O God, receive these gifts as you receive us. Like a mother receives her child with arms open wide, nourish us anew in your tender care and empower us in faithful service to tend to others with the same love through Jesus Christ, our saving grace. Amen. Hear the Eucharistic prayer for this day. O God, most mighty, O God, most merciful, O God, our rock and our salvation, hear us as we praise, call us to your table, grant us your life. When the world was a formless void, you formed order and beauty. When Abraham and Sarah were barren, you sent them a child. When the Israelites were enslaved, you led them to freedom. Ruth faced starvation. David fought Goliath. And the psalmist cried out for healing and full compassion. You granted the people your life. You entered our sorrows. In Jesus our brother, he was born among the poor and he lived under oppression. He wept over the city. With infinite love, he granted the people your life. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." And after supper, he took the cup. Again, he gave thanks, gave it for all to drink, saying, this cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in remembrance of me. Remembering his death, we cry out, amen. Amen. Celebrating his resurrection, we shout, amen. Amen. Trusting his presence in every time and place, we plead, amen. O God, you are breath. Send your spirit on this meal. O God, you are bread. Feed us with yourself. O God, you are wine. Warm our hearts and make us one. O God, you are fire. Transform us with hope. O God, most majestic, God most motherly, O God, our strength and our song, you show us a vision of the tree of life, with fruits for all and leaves for the healing of nations. Grant us such life, the life of a father to the Son, the life of the Spirit of our risen Savior, life in you, now and forever. Amen. And let us pray in the words that our Savior has given us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Beloved, here is bread, here is wine, here is Jesus. Be fed. The body of Christ given for you. The blood of Christ shed for you. For those of you who are not receiving communion this day, know that you have been blessed by God, by receiving God's word in your heart and into your lives.
I freely give.
prayer after communion. Christ Jesus, at this table we have feasted on your very life and are strengthened for our journey. Send us forth from this banquet nourished in body and in spirit to proclaim your good news and serve others in your name. Amen. Several announcements for the week to come. We have text studies, as we have mentioned, on each Sunday at 11 a.m. We review the text that we've had. We kind of talk about a little bit about the sermon, and then we share communion. And we've been getting more response on this, and so it feels good to offer this for many people that are working and others who aren't available on Wednesdays. So please join us if you get a chance. You will receive the invite in emails this next week. A Bible study on Wednesday, the 27th, is at 11 o'clock. We will be in Genesis chapter 5, about the generations, and chapter 6, about the wickedness of humanity. Join us for that at 11 on Wednesday. It is posted at 6 p.m. for your review and participation. We have a high tea and happy hour on the 28th, Thursday, 4 p.m. It's a Zoom conversation. Please let us know if you need more information on that. Next Sunday, the annual meeting will happen January 31st, 11 a.m. In-person sign-up should be done through the church office. Copies of the 2021 budget and annual report have been emailed to you, or you can pick them up in the fellowship hall. Delivery is also an option. Just call the office and we can get that information to you. Birthdays this week, Claire and Emma Dovish on the 24th, James Grady on the 24th, Patricia Cross on the 25th, and Diane LaFrenz on the 26th. We have no anniversaries happening this week. So I believe that those are our announcements. So receive God's blessing. God the Creator, strengthen you. Jesus the Beloved, fill you. And the Holy Spirit, the Comforter, keep you in peace. Amen. Go in peace. Be the light of Christ. Thanks be to God. Have a great week. And many blessings to you. Amen.
Day by day, and with each passing moment, strength I find to meet my trials here. Trusting in my Father's wise bestowment, I've no cause for worry or for fear. He whose heart is kind beyond all measure gives unto
says, O Lord, that I lose not faith's sweet consolation.